Well, you know, folks, marriage is a beautiful thing. It can be a beautiful thing between two people who really love and adore and care about each other. It can be. But marriage may not be such a beautiful thing when tragedy strikes. Stay tuned. Get what you think, because this is my channel. Forget about your feelings, because the truth is hard to handle. Tick, 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 tock. Popcorn, popcorn, pop, tart, fart. Leave a racist comment and you will get blocked. Shelton Harrison, there never be no comparison. You're live on the show, sit back and have a listen. And that's just the way that is. All right. LDBC, it is your boy Coach Shelton Harrison. You're live on the Coach Shelton Harrison Combat Sports Show Live. And welcome to my video, Crime of Jealousy or Crime of Passion. Guys, this is not a boxing or MMA video, so please, guys, if this is not your cup of tea, cut the video off right now. Let's start. Okay, folks, you know, this was a strange story. The woman that you see at the bottom, her name is Rachel Del Tondo. Rachel Del Tondo, she was murdered in her mother's driveway on Mother's Day. And guys, the story gets even stranger. Like, and it's kind of weird that she was actually murdered on Mother's Day night in her mom's driveway. Rachel Del Tondo was shot 10 times in the stomach. But my reason for the video is not really about Rachel Del Tondo. My reason for the video is about the young man that you see on the upper left-hand corner. His name is Sheldon Jeter. Okay, his name is Sheldon Jeter. And the reason why that I'm actually making this video in defense of him is because I feel like the media, they're trying to legitimately pin this on him. They're trying to pin it on him. And so let's really get into, you know, the justification of this video. Rachel Del Tondo, about 2 years ago, was caught. You know, she was caught in a car, okay, at 2 a.m. in the morning. She was caught in a car. The windows were fogged up. And she was with Sheldon Jeter. Now, Sheldon Jeter, at the time, he was about 17 years old. She was in the car with him. The windows fogged up. But the story takes a strange turn. The police, you know, they came to the scene and they, you know, somebody reported the car, a mysterious car just sitting there. And I guess they saw them in the car. And the police came and investigated it. And when Rachel Del Tondo rolled the window down, she was laying back in the seat. And he was on the other, he was on the passenger side. And so Rachel Del Tondo quickly just said, hey, you know, he was really having a tough time and he needed somebody to talk to. And, you know, I'm just trying to help him out. Isn't that what all pedophiles say? Have you ever seen them shows where they catch these guys red handed and they always say that they're just trying to, you know, mentor the kid so the kid don't get in trouble? See, now the person is a kid, you know, and after they done sent all these text messages to try to entice these young kids, and then when they finally get caught, you know, trying to meet them, the police waiting on them, they always say that they're just trying to help them. They're just trying to offer some advice to them, you know, like, yeah, like, we didn't know that you were trying to have relations with a minor, okay? Rachel Del Tondo was a pedophile, okay? But, you know, here's what happened. The police, they took him home. They allowed her to leave. The police allowed this woman to go home to her house, okay? Nobody wrote, you know, they didn't press any charges against her. They just wrote an incident report, which, you know, those can go unnoticed for years. And that's what happened. So, you know, she worked at a job. She worked at a charter school. She worked at a job, continued to work. And, you know, nothing happened until an email leaked out. I don't know how the email from the police department got out there, but somebody knew somebody that knew somebody that this email leaked out. And so she was suspended from her job pending an investigation. Okay. But all they needed to do was read the police report, and the school would have known that what this woman was up to, okay? This woman was in a car with a 17-year-old young man, okay? 17, you know, that's not legal age. She was in the car with him, and the windows were fogged up. What the hell do you think was happening in that car? I bet you a lot of you could probably figure it out. Now, let's talk about the two gentlemen. Let's talk about her fiancé, okay? She was dating this guy, Frank, okay? Frank Katropa, for 8 years. And I'm going to tell you something, man. You know, looking at this woman's social media, just researching her, you know, this woman was out there. You know, she was out there like, she was more so seeking attention. And Frank Katropa, I'm sorry, man, this dude was a mark. This dude was a mark, okay? He was a rich mark. This guy's a millionaire many times over. And, you know, he snagged a woman that looked good. And I'm going to tell you, man, she wasn't happy. Because if she were happy with him, she wouldn't have been, you know, wrapped up with some 17-year-old. I'm just telling you what's up, okay? She was not happy. Frank Katropa was a mark. He was probably one of these guys, you know, that saw her and, you know, started, you know, flaunting a little bit of money. You know, probably charmed her a little bit. But, you know, she was probably after the money. and probably tried to sneak off with old boy here on the left side while, you know, he was spending money. You know, he was going to be the pocketbook while old boy was going to provide the pleasure. Folks, I'm just calling it like I see it. But Frank Cotropa was a mark. He was a mark, and pretty much he was a simp. Okay? This is a simp. But, you know, the media, though, they're doing a good job of trying to, you know, make it seem like that it's, you know, Sheldon Jeter. They're trying to make it seem like he actually was the one that pulled the trigger. See, it's all subliminal. But see, this not the funny part, though. The story takes a turn right here again. So, you know, remember I told you guys that the cops, they didn't even, you know, they didn't write a report. They didn't even write this up. They didn't even file charges with her being in the car with an underage boy. They ain't filed charges. Get this. So Rachel Del Tondo had another female with her at the time of the murder, right? This female didn't get shot. No bullets hit this female. All 10 bullets hit Rachel Del Tondo. But the thing of it is, the girl who Rachel Del Tondo was with was the daughter. This was the daughter of one of the cops that found him in the parking lot. Now, how you gonna explain this? Well, now we know exactly why that a police report, an incident report was written, but now we know why no charges were filed. So Rachel Del Tondo was actually, I guess, was friends or was a mentor to this cop's daughter. This cop knew Rachel Del Tondo. So this cop covered this up. Now, I wonder how they're going to question this cop. I wonder if they're going to question this cop, and I wonder if they're going to, you know, have anything, you know, say anything to him for covering this whole thing up. Because that's what he did. It was two cops. And I guess the other cop who was with him probably thought that, yeah, you know, hey, I'm going to just write this up for you. I'll write it up, and I'll take care of it. Don't you worry about it. And, you know, that happens all the time. One police officer will do the paperwork and press the charges. But, you know, that other cop, you know what? It might be his job on the line. See, the police force, they dirty. Everybody dirty in this picture. And now the media, you got the media out here running around here talking about, well, this young boy, Sheldon Jeter, he was frantically, you know, like texting her trying to find this woman the day she got killed. He was frantically texting her. I'm going to tell you something, man. I guarantee you that these two, even after Rachel Del Tondo got caught in the car with this boy, I guarantee you that she was still seeing him. Because, see, pedophiles, when the police, if you catch a pedophile and if you don't check the behavior, I'm telling you, they go off and they do the same thing again. They don't stop. It's a mental sickness. You don't cure a mental sickness with threats. You cure those with actions. This woman was still seeing this boy. I guarantee you that they were still, you check her phone records, check his phone, I bet you'll see that they was hooking up and hanging out. I promise you. Check her social media, check everything. But I guarantee you this woman, these two were getting together and they were hanging out still. But see, I don't think he did it. I don't think he rolled up on him. But see, not if he was already getting exactly what he wanted from her. And he'd been pretty much hanging out with her since he was 17. Now he's 20. I'm not saying he could not have did it, but this don't seem like he would actually do this. Not when he was already getting what he wanted. But I tell you who wasn't getting what they wanted. You guessed it. It's the man on the right. And let me tell you something, too, about an alpha male. Frank Cotropa, he wasn't an alpha male, but he was more of a simp. But he was an aggressive businessman that he's one of those simps that they used to getting what they want. Because they don't have much of a personality. All they have is money. And see, when you're a guy that all you have is money, you have to buy what you want. He was buying Rachel Del Tondo. I don't care what you say. Okay, guys? That's just what it is. He was buying a woman. And so at a certain point in time when money, you can't buy somebody that you can have chemistry with. You can't buy that. Either you have chemistry or you don't have chemistry. But I'll make another channel, a Deep Thinkers channel, guys, and I'll invite about 10 of y'all, and I'll really explain what's going on. But I can't do it on this video, and I can't do it in this arena. But I'm telling you now, Frank Cotropa was a mark. He was a mark, man, and she played this dude like a simp. But see, it might have turned wrong. See, this dude was acting real scary, and in my opinion, he hiding something. And when they're asking him about them questions, you know, you see how this dude, you know, he started looking around a little bit, and he started blinking real fast. I'm like, yo, what is up with all that? This dude got, is he got Tourette syndrome? Or, I mean, what's going on with him? Nah, man, he hiding something. And I can tell you this right now, man. Guys like him, they get what they want. And when they don't get what they want, they don't want nobody to have it. And that's just the way that is. You guys tell me what you think about this whole, you know, plot of jealousy and passion. This is your boy, Coach Shelton Harris. I'm done. What are you waiting on? Subscribe.